Hello, Senor, Senorita, and my lovely little factory owner. My name is Zeno, the crazy German engineer. Welcome to my weapon test chamber. The mod we are looking at today is called Shock Turrets, and it's one of my favorite turret mods of all time. Why? Well, because it closes a technology gap between the gun turret and the laser turret. The new shock turret fits perfectly in between. The best thing about the new shock turret is how early in the game you are able to research it. All you have to do is use the turret steel processing and military technology to unlock the shock turret research. Do it with red and green science and you are good to go to place your very first shock turret way before you could ever place your first laser turret. Once you unlock the shock turret, you can even improve it by researching shock turret damage or shock turret speed. Keep in mind, later in this video when I show you how good this tower is in combat, that I researched level 7 of damage and shooting speed. So when you first have this tower available in your game, early in the game, it won't be as strong as you see it here. And one more thing to note, you even have a technology that lets you upgrade your shock turrets into laser turrets later in the game. The upgrade possibility is the reason you have two laser turret icons in your combat crafting menu. On the right side is a normal vanilla laser turret. It uses 20 steel plates, 12 batteries and 20 electronic circuits. On the left side is a new laser turret recipe that uses only 10 steel plates, 12 batteries as well, and only 15 electronic circuits, but it needs one shock turret to be done. And it does not matter which way you produce your laser turret, with or without a shock turret, it does not matter because in the end you get a normal laser turret that can be stacked with each other, so you don't need two different item slots to have two different kinds of laser turrets, it's the exact same entity. Now, of course, the number one reason you want to use the shock turret is because they don't need any ammunition. As long as you have enough electricity, they can fire upon the enemy. Chances are, at least once you had this moment when a big swarm of biters attacks your base in the early game, just for you to realize somewhere on a different corner of your factory is a gun turret without ammunition and the biters just tear it down, run into your factory and cause big problems. The shock turret is a perfect answer in that case. Now let's see how they act in combat. They have a range of 19 and a base shooting speed of 2.4 and a damage of 8. Now I said earlier in this video I researched shooting speed and damage up to research number 7, so they are a lot stronger than in the early game. And that's why I will use Beomod Biter to show their strength. These biters are not modded at all, but are sitting here with evolution factor 100, so these are the strongest enemies you should encounter in Vanilla Factorio, if you do not mod the enemies. You can see the shock turrets are shooting very quickly, but the Beomod biters have such high resistance against electricity damage that they have no problem to breach our defense. But what can we say? These towers are made for the early game anyway, and you can believe me, you should try it for yourself. They really shine versus small biters. Now you know everything you need to use your shock turrets and make your factory a little bit safer in the early game. No more towers running out of ammunition and biters swarming your factory. If you are curious and want to test the mod for yourself, just click on the video description below the video and you will find a link that brings you to the mod page, as well as a link to my Patreon page if you are interested in supporting me. My name is Zeno, I'm the crazy German engineer. Thanks for watching, give me a thumbs up, share my videos, and we will see us in the next video. Goodbye, and always remember, the factory must grow. Special thanks to Cyberbone.